Hey Kevin here, Mr. DIY Dork from DIYDork.com. Today I have a really interesting video for you. As you've probably seen in my other video, we're right in the middle of an exterior renovation of our barn house, and we're kind of waiting on new metal to show up because some of it got damaged. So while we're in flux waiting for it, I decided on a whim yesterday to just make something really awesome. So I decided to make a table using scrap wood that we had left over from when we redid the interior of the house. And I didn't have any plan or any idea of what I really wanted to make, but it turned out really awesome. Also, one more thing is, I think I may have called it chevron in the video, but I think the pattern is actually herringbone. They look very similar, but I think it's called herringbone. It doesn't really matter, it's kind of a geeky thing anyway. So check this video out. I think you're really gonna like this one. But the first step is I'm going to go to Menards and grab a couple of table legs that I need, and everything else will be built out of scrap. But I'm really hoping I don't get distracted at Menards. But anyway, we'll go there and pick them up, and then I'll get started. Alright, so here's what I'm working with. I decided to use my scrap pile. I'm going to try to use as much of this as I can and come up with something interesting. And I also decided to go a little against the grain of what I normally do and not make it too polished and finished and painted and sanded nice and all that. And I'm going to keep this stuff pretty raw as is. So what I decided to do is, if you've seen some of my other videos, you know that we saved a bunch of wood that come out of our bathroom when we redid it, and also a downstairs bedroom. And you know, good pine wood, but man, it is ugly stuff. You can just see here how ugly it is. And what I'm gonna do is, you can kind of see right here, a big pile I took out, and I'm gonna turn them into a really cool coffee table. Keep them as is. They got paint splotches on them, they got scratches, they have ugly finish. All I'm gonna do is clean the dust off of them, and then I don't really like sharp corners, so I'm gonna slightly round corners off of them, and then put them all together in an interesting tabletop. So let me show you what I've come up with. Right, so you can see I piled all of the wood scraps together. I think they're all about 20 inches long and about 2¾ inches wide or so. I didn't measure real closely, and it doesn't really matter for this project because I'm just using them as is. So you can see I'm doing a kind of a tried and true chevron pattern. Maybe it's getting a little tired and old. You see a ton of them on Instagram, but you know, it's still kind of fun to make something like this. So what I'm gonna do, you can kind of see I did a step pattern where one goes this way and then one just butts up to it. If you look up close, you can see that right down the middle. And you can see just how ugly the wood is, and even had paint splotches on them, and there's like, that might be a bleach stain. I decided, like I said, to not go too polished, and I'm actually gonna keep them just like this. They are a little dusty, so I'm gonna clean the dust off. And then, like I said, I'm gonna sand and round the corners off. The other thing I'm gonna do is, I'm thinking these aren't totally square, so I'm gonna run them in my chop saw real quick and just make sure they're totally square. And then I'm gonna sand the edges so that they slightly round off, so there's gonna be a little divot in between them all. And it's also, what's gonna happen is they're gonna, you know, become raw pine, so there's gonna be little lines in between them. So I think everything's gonna be defined really well. But then, like I said, I'm gonna keep the paint splotches and the general ugliness. And I have these boards laid here. That's where I'm gonna chop the end, just straight across there. And I'm gonna chop that end off as well, so it just ends up being a square with kind of the chevron pattern. And then I'm gonna build a base, and I haven't quite figured that out because I said I don't really have a plan. And then I'm gonna use the really cool spindle legs like you've probably seen on my Ardex coffee table. And I'm use a couple of these and make it kind of interesting, have a more polished base, but then a rough top. I think it'd be a cool project, so check it out. All right, so now I'm making a base for all the chevron pieces to actually be attached to. So I had some leftover press board here. So I did the measure 24 inches this way and 36 inches that way. I'll cut this out, and we can start working from there. Just gotta have something to start with for all those pieces to fit on, and then we can fit framing and all that around all this. It'll just help hold it all solid. All right, so the baseboard has been cut down. You can probably just see I drew a line right down the middle. It's 24 inches wide, so I drew it right at 12 inches. So now what we gotta do is find center of this design. And one thing I figured out is that, see how there's a zigzag in the middle? The center is actually, it splits that zigzag right in half. So I was trying to figure out an easy way to do it, and I thought back to high school, and I guess it'd been geometry class or whatever. So what I did was I decided to end right at this point, okay? So at the edge of that board, all the way to the edge of that board happens to be 36 inches. So what I did was I pulled this board out, I took it to my chop saw, and I cut it exactly at a 45, okay? See that? Then from this point to that point, when you go over this way, I decided to not pull out Pythagorean theorem, because this isn't totally exact. I'm doing Carpenter theorem, I guess you could say. And I just measured it, and it's almost 2 inches from this point to that point. It's like 1 7/8. So I'm finding halfway of that, which is like, what, 15/16? So it's basically an inch. So I think being 1/16 off, no one's ever gonna know. So you probably can't see it, but I drew a little tiny tick mark at 1 inch, and that is actually the center. So now what I'm gonna do is take this board, lay it on here, and then I can line up this edge plus the little tiny tick mark. You can probably just see it shine in there. I can line it up with the center line, and now I can clamp that board down. That's why I have the clamps. I'm gonna clamp it down, and then every other board can be built off of that. So it's like the way to do it when you really don't know what you're doing, you're trying to figure it out, and you're just going by the simplest method you can think of. So I'll fill this out. Then what we can do is we can take a pencil and just drag it underneath the edge, and then we'll be able to cut all these sides off there. Right, now if you need to visualize what I just said, because I'm more of a visual learner, you can see this piece right here, I clamped just like I told you, and then the other piece, the corner met right at the corner of that one. So then I just tightened both of those down with clamps, so now you can just start laying out a pattern like this. Okay. Lay every single piece on there, and then you can see there is some pieces hanging off here at the edge. So what we'll do is once we fill it out, I'll just take a pencil underneath and drag it along the bottom sides of these, and we'll know exactly where to cut them. Now, for the pieces right here, we'll just kind of do the same thing, but work from the opposite way. Once all those are all, dealt with, then we'll come here, we'll lay a piece on, and we'll drag on this side and that side, cut it, and just keep working down until we get to the smaller pieces. Then I'm gonna go through and sand them and all that, and then we can actually start putting them on here and then build the framing and base and all that from there. All right, one more thing you can probably see I did is I put a piece of tape on all the boards and I numbered them from left side down and then from right side down. And that way they'll keep them all in order whenever I take them all apart and start to sand them and everything. I'll know which side's up and all that kind of stuff. It'll just help place them a little better.